Hey y'all, I am back with another video. I want to take a moment to talk about homophobic straight black men. As boring and as tired and unimpressive and problematic and as smelly as they are, because you know they don't believe in washing in between their butt cheeks, so you know they stink. They spend so much time focusing on black gay men. And so they obviously want some of our attention, so we need to talk about them a little bit. Starting with hip-hop culture. You know, hip-hop culture has a stronghold on black men, period. The way that we are expected to express our emotions or not express our emotions. Also, there is an emphasis placed on masculinity in our community, and not just in the black community, but even in the black gay community. It's a certain type of way we are expected to show up and be. You know, and if you don't show up like that, it's like you get shunned. Even in the black gay community, you get shunned for not showing up and presenting a certain type of way. We see that in bottom shaming. We see that even in our personal relationships where we are afraid to truly be open and authentic, because we have been taught that feelings and all those different things and being expressive, all those are weak and feminine. That in itself is a contradiction, because many of these men who embrace this toxic idea of masculinity were raised and are inspired by a grandmother who probably had to go clean houses and stuff to make a living, or a mother or an aunt who had to work two or three jobs to take care of them. Some of them live with some woman who has to work two or three jobs and is financing their sorry ass. And if it wasn't for that woman, who knows where they would be? Even a lot of black gay men who walk around embracing this idea of masculinity are inspired by music from Beyonce or Rihanna or Normani, Patti LaBelle. These are women, and they are the soundtracks of our lives, which shows how influential feminine strength and femininity is to all of us. And not to get too deep into this, but we have both masculine and feminine energies. Okay, so whether you like it or not, straight boys, y'all got it in there. And this has nothing to do with feminine energy, but low-key, a lot of y'all are the biggest bitches there are on the planet, even with the way that you take care of your families. Which brings me to another point, because we as black gay men, we get looked at as weak. You know, a lot of straight black men who are homophobic will project certain weaknesses onto us when we are the ones in the community taking up all the slack. If you look at our community, if you look at gay men, if you look at lesbians, but primarily black gay men, and you look at the community, whether it be political movements like the March on Washington, where Bayard Rustin, who was a black gay man, was the organizer. He was Dr. Martin Luther King's right-hand man, but he was erased. His visibility was erased from the movement simply because he was an out black gay man in the 1960s. This continues to happen in our communities. We are very prevalent in the churches, even though the church is starting to become irrelevant. I think that's the right word. I hope so. As I get older and be trying to say these words, I'd be regretting skipping school all them days. But even though the church is becoming irrelevant, black gay men are still there. We are in there writing the hymns and directing the choirs, but we are not allowed to stand up and fully be present. In our families, we are the ones who take care of the children that a lot of these straight black men come and have with these women and then abandon. And most of these kids, if you look around in our community and have conversations with a lot of single black women, a lot of them do have a gay male best friend who helps them with their child, who ends up stepping in as a father figure to that child. You even see it in television. There was this show that used to come on the OWN network called Raising Whitley, and Kim Whitley, her best friend was Wendell, and they had a couple of other gay men who was helping her raise Joshua. And that's just one example, but that is something that's very prevalent in our community. What boggles my mind though is even though we are stepping up and filling in the gaps where a lot of these straight black men are not stepping up in, we also get shunned. Some of these same people who we help with their children, you know, they're okay having a gay best friend or having you be their kid's uncle. But if their child was to come out of the closet and say, hey, mom, I'm gay, a lot of them would disown their children, which speaks to how our community continues to be influenced about issues around sexuality. Even in the church, you know, you can serve, you can walk the pastor to the pulpit with his Bible. You can sleep with him after the service because, you know, the pastor be getting his back blown out and doing all kinds of other stuff after those services. And I'm just telling the truth. You can do all that because there's a lot of sexual secrets in the church. But Lord forbid you stand up in there and say, I want to publicly declare my love to my partner. Then here again, you become invisible. But in a lot of these black families and in the black community, a lot of these straight black men who, I'm not saying all straight black men, I want to put emphasis on that. I am saying a lot of these homophobic straight black men, because they come with a whole lot of other issues. They look at sexuality as a weakness. And so in themselves, a lot of the traits that are important for a healthy manhood, a lot of traits that we should be embracing as men, totally, you know, they don't embrace those traits and they look at them as weak. And so they will say, if my son prefers to, and this is if they're taking care of the kid in the first place. And sometimes they're not taking care of the kid, but when they come to the house, they borrow that $20 from their baby mama, and they just so happen to notice that their son prefers to paint rather than play football, they also will either beat the hell out of the child, try to beat some manhood into them, or they will totally abandon that child emotionally and just won't be there for that child, period. And then, like I said, we have to come in, and a lot of time we take up the slack, or other women come in and take up the slack. I get tired of having to clean up behind these folks. I get tired of seeing these men proclaim to be the leaders of our community while everybody else does their work, but while doing their work are expected to be invisible, are expected to be abused and okay with being abused, while they don't only beat up on gay men, but some of these men, they also are predators. Okay, they molest these little girls that are in our families and who are in our churches, and these underage girls who come to these clubs and stuff like that. You know, a lot of them beat their girlfriends. They abandon their children. You know, they are verbally violent. They are emotionally absent from our community. But at the same time, there is always a seat for them at the family reunion or at the church or at any other function or gathering that we have. And not just the seat, but we will give them the biggest piece of chicken. And that's some bullshit. We all know it's some bullshit. I also have a problem with the people in our community who know better, but refuse to hold them accountable. They're just as bad. And we really need to just stop listening to these people, because they don't, what they say, it doesn't matter, because when it comes to action, actions that are meaningful, actions that add value to our community, they contribute none. And so they're not important. And I don't even know why we respond to these folks, but the conversation needs to continue. And hopefully some sort of shift will occur in our community where we're able to understand and see this exactly for what it is. Because when it comes to masculinity, it's really not about who you are sleeping with. And manhood, it's about how you are providing, how you are showing up through action for the community and your family. How are you as a citizen? And I have seen too many women show up in ways that are more effective than a lot of these men. I have seen too many trans folks and black gay folks show up and step up and lift our community up and hold our community up to know better. And hopefully you do too. What do you think about it? And what can we do to deal with this sort of ignorance? Because I'm tired of it. Please leave your comments. Also, subscribe to the channel, turn on your notifications, and thank you for listening. See you next time.